Hello everybody, in this video we are going to teach you how to install from scratch CentOS 7 Linux in a dedicated server. Okay, the first step is to go to the CentOS.org website to download the CentOS distribution. Okay, in the CentOS site we click here, Get CentOS Now. Now we can choose between the DVD, the everything ISO, or the minimal ISO. In my example, I'm going to use the minimal, okay, but the procedure is the very, very same for each type of distribution you get. The difference is that the DVD ISO have the standard components and the everything ISO have some more tools, okay? So I'm clicking in the minimal link. Afterwards, we go to the mirror list, okay. Now we must choose the location where we wish to download from, okay. You should choose your country, so let's pick anyone, for instance this one. Now you have several types of distributions here. You can choose the version you wish to install. You are getting the version 7.2, which is the latest. Now, there are several options, but the little trick is you must download the ISOs. Just dismiss the other ones and click in ISOs. Now, I'm going to pick the 64-bit version. Okay, now I can choose between the minimal version or maybe the everything, which is the complete version, or maybe the standard version, DVD. Okay, the procedure is the very same, so I'm going to download this one, the minimal, okay, which is slightly quicker to install. So just download this ISO, okay, we're going to come back right after the download is completed. Okay, so right after we finish downloading the ISO, we must burn it into a DVD disk, okay? Then just boot the server, the PC, with this DVD. And now the installation begins, okay? So move the cursor to install CentOS 7 and hit Enter. Afterwards, just hit Enter again to begin the installation. Okay, so now the graphical part of the installation begins. We must choose our language here. Okay, you can choose any language of your choice. We're going to pick English and your specific. Okay, I'm going to choose English from the UK. So let's click continue here in the bottom. Okay, now we must choose, first of all, our time zone. Just clicking here and date time. Okay, so just click in your specific time zone. Okay, let's click done. Now we must choose our keyboard layout. Okay, if your keyboard isn't this one, just click in the plus icon and select the layout from here. Here you can perform some tests. Okay, let's just click done. If you prefer, you can just change the language. Click in here, language support. There are several languages you can choose from. Okay, afterwards, just click done. So let's scroll a little the screen with the mouse. Here in software selection, as we are using the minimal distribution, we can only use the minimum install, but you can, if you download a bigger version, you can have other options here, okay? But for this example, the minimum will do fine. Just click done afterwards. Now, first of all, click in installation destination, okay? We must select our partition where we're going to place the Linux. just click here in your hard disk, okay? After click here, just click done. That means we are selecting this hard disk to receive the Linux. Just click done. Okay, so now just click in network and hostname. And you must click here to enable your network. Okay, by clicking on, the network is now enabled. Okay, it just got the IP address from my router. Now, if you prefer, you can just click configure. By default, the Ethernet card will be set to DHCP. For a dedicated server, you'd better go here to IPv4 settings. Okay, and in method, if you have a fixed IP address or a public IP address, just click here and set to manual. Now you must click add and then type your IP address here. So for instance, now the netmask and the gateway. Okay, now the DNS servers. Okay, so after you configure this, okay, just click save. Okay, now I have my valid and public IP address configured. Okay, this is an optional configuration. You should just do this if you are in a data center. Yes, if you are in a home connection, you should use DHCP according to your provider. Okay, now we can configure here your host name. So for instance, we are going to place test server 10.copperhost.com as the host name. Now we'll click done. Okay, let's roll the mouse to the bottom. My network card is connected. Okay, and then let's click begin installation. Okay, so the installation process takes several minutes. Yes, you can see here the progress bar and the task which is being performed right now. During the installation, we must configure our root password. So let's click here in root password, and then we're going to type the desired password. That's it. Now we click done. So that's it. So we must now wait for the installation to finish. Yes, it takes several minutes. I'm going to accelerate the video, okay, so that it's better for you to watch. And then we're going to come back as soon as the installation is finished. Okay, so now the installation is completed. We must click in Reboot. Okay, so now that we finished our installation, our server will reboot. And as you are prompted for the kind of boot you wish, just click Enter, okay? Even if you don't click Enter, CentOS will enter automatically, okay? Okay, so the installation is completed. Now, just to log in, just type root, which is the administration user, and then type your password, the same as you choose it during the installation. So that's it, we are inside the Linux, this is completely installed. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Okay, thanks for watching, bye bye, see you next time.